So you finally finished building your app and you're ready to get it up on the App Store. But you're here staring at App Store Connect, looking at this screen and like, oh, I need screenshots. And then you remember, oh, these are really important because good App Store screenshots can be the difference between a user downloading your app or a competitor's app. And you're probably not a designer, so this feels daunting. Don't worry, I got you. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to get App Store screenshots uploaded fast and easy using a tool that I use called AppScreens. You can choose from a ton of pre-designed templates for your screenshots. And if you like what you see, you're good to go. Or you can take those templates, tweak them, customize them to really make them your own. And if your app is localized into other languages, AppScreens will localize your screenshots as well. And the nice thing, you can upload all these screenshots with one click. You don't have to waste your time exporting and dragging and dropping all these screenshots into App Store Connect. This video is sponsored by AppScreens, so if you like what you see here, check them out. Link's in the description. All right, so you're looking at App Store Connect and you got this blank area for your screenshots here for the iPhone. So let's talk about the requirements, because if you go view all sizes in Media Manager, you can see for the iPhone, you got the 6.9 display, the 6.5 display, all the different iPhone sizes, even the old ones with the old chin. But don't worry, you don't have to create App Store screenshots for every single version of these because they all have different dimensions because the phone size is different. Now, it defaults to the 6.5 display, but a little tip here is if you upload screenshots for the 6.9 display, which are the bigger iPhones, the App Store will show those screenshots for all of the other displays, so you don't have to create so many variations, a huge time saver. And here are the dimensions for the 6.9 display that you need to create your screenshots in, but don't worry about memorizing these because these change all the time as Apple releases new devices. You can always come here and check them out, or if you use AppScreens, you don't have to worry about it. Now, another thing that catches people off guard is that even if you only have an iPhone app, you don't have an iPad version, you still need iPad screenshots. And that is because your iPhone app will still run on the iPad. It'll just look like an iPhone. I mean, it's a horrible user experience, to be honest with you, but it still happens. So you will have to have iPad screenshots. So the same thing applies here. As long as you have screenshots for the 13-inch display, you will get the screenshots for all the other iPads, no matter the dimensions. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna use AppScreens to create iPad 13-inch display and iPhone 6.9-inch display, and that'll have us covered. So back to our app. Let me show you real quick how to take screenshots of your app. Here in Xcode, I have two simulators running, one for the iPhone, one for the iPad. And you can have up to 10 screenshots for your App Store Connect page. You don't necessarily have to have all 10, but I would definitely have a minimum of 3, because as you can see here on the App Store, 3 of them show up as user is scrolling. So you absolutely want to have at least 3. But the idea here is to go through your app, point out all the cool stuff it can do. Like there's a schedule, here's the different money stuff. And then on the iPad, you got the schedule here, you know, the different money stuff for this particular app. So go ahead and take the screenshots. Now how you do that, you see this little camera button up here? You click that and you see your screenshot goes there and it'll be on your desktop. So that's a quick and easy way. And as you can see in my Finder here, I've already done this before the video to save some time. I've taken the screenshots I wanted. You can see here's the iPad versions on my screens, and I have them organized in an iPad folder and an iPhone folder, which I highly recommend you do, because if you're going and taking a ton of screenshots, this gets messy real fast, so organization is key. And once we have our screenshots, now we can go over to AppScreens to start bringing those screenshots into these pre-existing design templates. We're here at appscreens.com. See, they got a nice little video showing you everything you can do. You can scroll through the website, check out all that they offer, but we're gonna get right into it and we're going to create screenshots fast. So click on AI Screenshot Creator and you'll walk through a wizard. Now, if your app is uploaded on the App Store, you can search for the app on the App Store. I'm showing you the use case where you haven't uploaded your app yet. So you can hit create manually. And then what you need to do is do the app name. So mine is Creator View. And the bundle IDs. Go to Xcode in general, get your bundle ID, copy that and paste it here. Same thing if you have your Android ID, I don't. And then we'll go ahead and create the app. Now, what it will do if it's actually on the App Store, it will go out, look, and grab the metadata of your app and help create your App Store screenshots based on that metadata. But we don't have our app on the App Store. So what we can do, if we go back to App Store Connect, if you already have your description on your App Store Connect page, go ahead and just copy and paste that in. Or as you can see here, you can paste in your App Store description or just write about your app's features. Just write a quick paragraph, tell it what your app does. Basically, AppScreens is gonna use this to create the text on your App Store screenshots. So I've pasted in my app description there, hit save and generate, and it's generating your screenshots and the text on it based on some good ASO best practices. In here, you get a short form version. You see channel control, take charge of your channel, analytics hub, track key performance metrics, smart planning, plan your content efficiently. That would be my schedule. So it pulled my App Store description, and these are going to be the titles on my App Store screenshots. You can have a short form version, or if you click long form, you see there's a longer form version depending on the style of screenshot that you're going to. And of course, in the editor, you can change these if you don't like exactly what it gave you, but it's a great starting point. So now we want want to select our template. And then, like I said, there are tons of pre-designed, beautifully made, ready to go templates. This is what I was saying. Like, if you're not a designer, AppScreens has you covered. You don't have to design all your screenshots yourself. And if you like one of the templates as is, you're just gonna bring in your screenshots that we took on the simulator, hit upload, and you're done. Great. But let's say you wanna tweak one of these templates, right? It's not exactly what you want. Well, AppScreens allows you to do that. So I'm gonna pick this one, this inner glow one, because that kind of looks like my brand, what I'm going for. So I'm gonna hit select template, and it pulled in those titles, right? The channel control analytics hub. It doesn't have any screenshots yet, right? We haven't uploaded that. What we're doing right now is we're just selecting our template that we want, our design. So I'm gonna hit save and edit, and then name it creator view. And then now output sizes. So this is where you can determine what sizes you want. Obviously we're not gonna have Android, so we're gonna unclick that. But you notice the red eye here next to the 6.9 and the 13 inch, that is basically saying that if you export these sizes, you're gonna get all the other sizes. And as you can see, here's your options of what you can export. Again, we're just gonna do the iPad 13 inch, the iPad 16.9. And then languages, we're not gonna have any languages right now, but if your app was localized into Spanish, French, German, you would pick these and then the screenshots would get translated into those as well. And then again, when you hit that upload to App Store Connect button, all the screenshots go to the proper languages, the proper devices, all that stuff. That saves so much time. And another thing too, even if you don't have other localizations besides English, well, English is a little different between like the US, Australia, Britain. For example, in the US, we call it candy. Well, in Australia, they call it lollies. And in the UK, they call it sweets. So even if all you have is English, you can have different variations on English. And again, AppScreens translates all that for you, has you covered for all of that. So let's hit create. And here we are in AppScreens. We have all of our screenshots. Now, before we upload our screenshots, I only have 5 screenshots for the sake of this example. Like I said, you can have any number of them. So I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I'm going to delete these last 3 just to clean it up. You'll see when I upload my screenshots, I don't want anything like extra here. So that'll leave us with 5 screenshots. So now when I hit AppScreens here, we're gonna upload our device screenshots. You can see I have screen 1, screen 2, screen 3, screen 4, screen 5. And here I have the iPhone 16.9 and the iPad 13 inch. Now, if I go back to my Finder, so channel control, we'll call this our dashboard. So I'm gonna look for my dashboard screenshot. There it is on the iPhone. I can just drag it in here to the iPhone and then back to the Finder, go to the iPad, find the dashboard. There it is, drag it into the iPad. Now I'm only gonna do one more screen, like you don't wanna watch me drag and drop so many. And then for screen 2, the text I got is Analytics Hub. Okay, so we'll do our analytics screenshots. Again, back to Finder, I'm on the iPhone. Here's my analytics screenshot for the iPhone, cool. Back to Finder, iPad, analytics screenshot, cool, there we go. Now, I'm gonna edit here, I'm gonna upload the rest of my screenshots. You don't wanna watch me drag and drop those all in. It's boring and repetitive, so see you in a second. All right, I've brought in the rest of my screens, so now I'm gonna hit save, and then you will see them populate here accordingly. So now, like I said, if you, for some reason, nailed the design, you like the design on the template you picked, now you can just hit upload and you're done. But we're gonna make some changes because I don't like the roundness of this font. You can see the color's not quite right, and I'm gonna change the background because I like a gradient that goes across all the screens, and I'm gonna change the device. So let's actually start off with the background here. We can pick gradient, and there's tons of customization options, by the way. I am just being brief, giving you an overview. I do have another video where I go really in depth into how to use AppScreens. You can check that out too, link will be in the description. But let's go to presets on the background, and what kind of gradient do I like here? Going, all right, this mirage, I still like the dark feel, so this mirage looks good. And I always like these screenshots where the gradient goes across all the screenshots, so the screenshots look cohesive. So you get that pretty easily, like look how quickly I just did that. And then now let's start editing this screen, because the cool thing is, once I edit this screen, I can just hit like apply all settings and I don't have to customize all the other screens. It's great. So let's start with the device. Here you can see a flat device mockup. You can see the color here. I'm gonna go real light. So now you can see the device is silver instead of black. And I like that because it pops. Now let's talk about the font here, this channel control. That color is not quite correct. So I'm gonna click on the font. I'm gonna highlight that channel and then I'm gonna pick the color. And then now I'm gonna do the eyedropper because I wanna pull the color right from my app so it matches perfectly. There you go. And then back to the font. The font family is Nanuto. You click on the font. Let's go with Roboto. It's a typical tech font. Hit select. And then you can make it bold. You know, you can do whatever you like here. And of course, you can continue to customize and tweak this all to your liking. I feel like that's enough for the demonstration. So now that I got what I want, I can hit this button right here. Copy settings. Copy from screenshot 1. We want this to go to all the screenshots. And I did the background settings, device style, text styles. And that's really all I did. So I'm gonna hit copy. Now you're gonna see the rest of these. You see the font changes, see the font color change. Now all my devices are silver as well. So we're good to go. I am ready to export. These are the changes I wanted. But you see how quickly and easily I got my screenshots in. I made some changes to make it look like my app, my brand, everything matches. Again, super fast and easy. Now that was just for the iPhone. We can go to the iPad and you can see those styles copied over. Look at the font. Look at the silver device outline. Look at the gradient going across the background. Boom, iPad screenshots. And again, if this isn't exactly what you want, there's a very powerful editor tool. Like you see me do all this. You can tweak all kinds of things. So the last thing we want to do is preview and export. And now we can preview what we have. Again, we only have the iPhone 6.9 and the iPad 13, but if you had multiple languages, if you had more device variety, this would all show up here and you can get a quick preview before you export and upload. Now you can download the zip of all these files, but that's the old way. Like you're gonna spend so much time going through that file, dragging and dropping to all the different languages, all the different devices. That's just such a waste of time. Upload to all app stores. You can authenticate your App Store Connect account with AppScreens. So AppScreens has the permissions to just upload these screenshots. I've already done that off screen because that takes a few minutes and I didn't want to bog down the video, but AppScreens has great documentation. It's pretty simple. They walk you through it. So I've already authenticated. So I want to hit upload to app stores. Now I need to connect my credentials to this. So I'm gonna hit upload to app stores. I haven't done my credentials, hit okay. So it pops up on the app. Remember when we added the app and added our bundle ID? Well, I forgot to do credentials. So you do that and then connect your App Store Connect. And then if you had Google Play, you would do that as well. But I only have the App Store Connect credentials. So hit select. Now that my credentials that I created when I authenticated my App Store Connect account with AppScreens are good to go. They're connected to the Creative View app. Hit upload to App Store. And it's gonna take a couple seconds to upload all this, but once this is done uploading, we'll go back to App Store Connect. We won't see them at all because I have to refresh App Store Connect, but I'm gonna show you this in real time. All right, it's uploading. All right, there we are. Exports away, cool. It's been uploaded, hit done. Now let's go back to App Store Connect. And okay, this is where we copy and pasted our description, if you remember. I don't have any screenshots. Oh, okay. View all sizes in Media Manager. 6.9, these are our screenshots that we just created. Boom, uploaded. And like I said, if you do the 6.9 display, here you go, you get it for all these other displays and it uses those screenshots. So super fast and simple. What about the iPad? Did we get our iPad screenshots in there? Boom, there's the iPad. And now we have it for all the other iPad displays as well. So there you go. Even if you're not a designer, you saw how fast and easy it was for me to get screenshots uploaded into AppScreens. Pick a great looking design. I could tweak the design and it took no time at all. So if you were staring at App Store Connect and you're like, oh man, how do I get these screenshots in here? And you're not a designer, AppScreens is a great tool. You should check them out. Link is in the description.